Danplan, the head of the Silver Age animation, for the odd ones out, Jaden Animation, something else, YTs of the world, we had Danplan. How could such a likable face of animation descend into an absolute farce headed by two individuals who have very cynical perspectives on each other? Today, we're going to take a deep dive into why Danplan died. Danplan channel was created by two individuals, Daniel and Hosa, on the 13th of July 2014, and they uploaded their first video, titled, By the Way, Moral of the Pooping Rubber, on the 2nd of August 2014, and has 453,000 views at the time of me recording. And for context, between the 6 years of Danplan's creation and January 5, 2020, the day of Actually Stevens' Actually I Quit Danplan video, they had spent a couple of years making their channel into gaming content, which was more popular at the time. This is also when they introduced Steven to the channel, and they had their first hit, By the Way, Are You a Psychopath?, which is obviously animation, and going forward, it was mostly Daniel, Hosa, Steven, and Jay. However, as 4 years passed and the Danplan channel grew, there was turmoil behind the scenes, and on January 4th, 2020, they released their final video with Steven in it, titled, By the Way, Can You Become a Superhero? The video was standard. They made it in the same style they did for 4 years, and nobody thought much of it. However, the video was ominously titled the final episode, and then Steven, one third of By the Way, announced that he quit Danplan.
Hey guys, sorry, but there won't be a stream this week. But I did want to give you guys an explanation about me and Danplan and just the future of this channel. So as the title of the video says, I've quit Danplan.
Steven outlines his issues that he had with Danplan, namely about their success, how he perceived it, and how much credit and payment he deserved from the channel's success, and gives an example in a month where the channel was making five figures, he'd receive just $225. This was based roughly around early 2019. Steven asked for 20% of Danplan's shares. Daniel rejected this proposal and told Steven that there was nothing that he could do to prove that he was worth a share, that he was just an employee.
Back in March of this year, I found out that Danplan made five figures from three videos in the span of a month, of which I was paid less than $300.
He says at multiple points that he tried to prove that he deserved a share.
I wasn't just an employee, but rather an integral founding member of the channel, and my contribution deserves acknowledgement. And so, for the past 9 months, I tried. God knows I tried. Every recording session, I brought my humor, my edge to the table. But I fought a losing battle. The more effort I put into developing my character, developing Steven, I realized how little Daniel valued it. Formal Mafia Steven, Huggy Zombie Apocalypse Steven, Hosa Steven. Daniel didn't give me a script to do those characters. I made them up, and I made my personalities enjoyable. But to Daniel, every recording session, I was merely talking to friends. To him, I wasn't putting in any effort into the videos. Every recording session, I wanted to swear at Daniel for real, to yell at him so much that I had to stop talking sometimes, or else I might say something I would regret the next day. And that feeling only grew each session. Until the last recording in November that we did, where I finally just zoned out and stopped trying at all. 9 months ago, when we argued, I asked Dan how many views on our videos were garnered by me. He said he didn't have an answer. A few weeks ago, I asked him the same question again, and his answer didn't change. So I know that no matter how hard I try, no matter how many personalities I perfect, Daniel will never consider me an equal on the channel. So I quit.
But he found the position unattainable. He finishes the video telling everyone to know their worth on their channel, because Dan won't recognize it, and he regrets being part of Danplan, because he thought that he could still call Daniel a friend had he not been a part of Danplan. After about a week, Steven conducted a 2-hour live stream titled Tidying Up My Desk After Leaving Danplan, which has since been unlisted and I can't find it, but it does exist, and if you find the link, please leave a comment and I will watch that stream. Steven said that he reached out to Daniel, but he had been met with radio silence on that front. Also said that when he dug into it, it became not just his problem, and that he did not realise how many people were getting screwed. He said he talked to Hosa about how much he was getting paid, and he said $28,000. Side note here, Stephen said he got the math wrong, and that Hosa made $42,000 Canadian dollars. Then he asked some animators about how much they were getting paid, and they said about $450 Canadian a month. We will come back to this point later, but keep it in your head. Before we dissect that lovely piece of information, we need to go back to an individual named Jack, who I said was one of the main characters alongside Hosa, Stephen, and Daniel. Jay and Stephen's personalities were remarkably similar, which led some people to theorize that Dan would replace Stephen with Jay. However, this point was disputed by Stephen himself, as he said, and I quote, "No one can emulate this greatness," which I myself perceive as arrogant, but that is what Stephen felt he was. And before Daniel would release his video, Jay released a video titled "Why I Say I'm Not a Part of Danplan." The original copy of this video doesn't exist anymore, and Jay himself has left the internet, most likely for good, as he has had multiple allegations which I don't feel comfortable commenting on. However, that does not mean I can't discuss his video. In the video, he says that around July 2019, he noticed that something was off, and decided to do a small investigation, and apparently found several internal problems, one of which was stating Dan split the revenue 50-50 with Hosa to leave out Stephen.
For any sort of recording. So, the recording sessions continue. We go to VidCon, Disneyland. All seems good until July of 2019. That's when things really started. So it's around this time, I guess, so July 2019, that I started to get a hunch or a feeling. I had a hunch that something was off with Danplan channel internally. So I decided to do a small investigation privately. And when Dan found out about it, that I was digging, he adamantly tried to make me drop it. He did not want me to dig around. And that is when I learned several extremely dangerous issues. The first issue that I found, the main one, was between the cast, main cast of Danplan, between Dan, Hosa, and Stephen, but mainly between Dan and Stephen. I found out that few years prior to the time of investigation, so 2019, so a few years prior to that, just as the channel was growing, Dan decided himself to split the channel's revenue 50-50 with himself and Hosa. He purposely left out Stephen.
Also, according to Jay, Hosa did not want any money from Danplan. He wanted the money to be invested back into the channel, but Dan said to take at least 15% of the channel's revenue, so it was 85% to Dan, 15% to Hosa.
On an important side note also, Hosa specifically told Dan that Hosa did not want the channel money. Hosa wanted Dan to use the money to grow the channel. But Dan later essentially pushed the money onto Hosa for at least 15%. So the Danplan revenue was split 85 to Dan, 15 to Hosa.
Jay also states that if you aren't an original, then you will get no shares in Danplan, and states that when Dan told Stephen that he's getting 0%, that he isn't even worth a percentage towards Danplan.
Talk about a share. I'll put a disclaimer right now. I don't study business. Business is not my forte, but I do know at least the fundamentals of it. A share has basically two meanings. There's the monetary definition, the money side, and there's the representation of how much you mean to a company. If you have 25% of a company share, you are part of, like, you are 25% of a company. And those two things are proportional to each other. Like, if the more you mean to a company, the more monetary benefit that you get. And so Stephen knew both of these definitions, and that's why he asked for shares as compensation for his work and for future contributions towards the channel that he helped grow. But for Dan, he had a very different, unconventional definition for shares. For Dan, a share was something precious. that the only the originals could get. Also, like, I just want to make a note that Dan's definition fluctuates greatly. Yeah. So, Dan's definition of share doesn't even revolve around money or business-wise. It's just a special title under a special lock. Are you an original? No, then you get nothing. That was Dan's mindset. When Dan told Steven that he's getting 0%, Dan implicitly told Steven not only that is he worth 0% towards Danplan, that he's not even a percentage worth towards Danplan, he pretty much also told him that he's not even viewed as an original.
Jay's final and most implicative claim of Danplan is the animation team for Danplan is, to quote Jay, a giant sweatshop, and says that $450 Canadian a month for full-time work figure was true, and that Dan had haggled an animator about pricing. During this time, Jay was going to replace host on the channel due to host's mandatory military service, and he asked if he would get shares implicitly. The answer was no, that he wouldn't be getting anything.
Two. It's a giant sweatshop. Originally, there were three animators when they just started off, Hosa included. Now they are at 12 without Hosa. They get paid an inconsistent $450 Canadian per month at best. And I have seen one example of Dan actually guilt-tripping and haggling animators for their pricing. During the investigation, I actually learned that I was going to be brought on board as a permanent member potentially. Now, I want to make this next part dead clear. I got Hosa's explicit green light. He gave me full permission to release this information. If you want to confirm it with Hosa, you can later, but I want to make this clear. I didn't force Hosa to agree to this. Hosa agreed to this willingly. Basically, I was supposed to replace Hosa. Hosa has already left to Korea for his mandatory military service for the next 2 years. So, I decided to ask Dan implicitly if I would get shares. The answer was no. I would get nothing. I was pretty much told the same thing as Steven, even though I was still technically one of the originals. I was there for, I believe, the second video and onward, but I wasn't original enough for Dan.
What it amounts to is Dan saying to Jay, don't dig around the channel, it's my channel. Jay's implication with that is, well, I'll let him tell you about what the implication was.
His reply to my investigation was, to quote him, to quote Dan again, Jay, from now on, don't ever interfere or dig around in the inner workings of the channel. It's my channel. What he implied with that was basically, he told me to fuck off when I was trying to help him.
He also states that Dan told him that he will run the channel according to his beliefs, and if it sinks, it sinks, and that he will go down with the ship.
And this was his response. To quote Dan, I don't care who leaves. This is my channel, and I will run it based on my belief. If it sinks because of that, it sinks. I have to give credit where credit is due. If you have that much gut on sticking to your belief, kudos to you. It's stupid, but kudos to you.
Dan uploaded a video on the 20th of January titled, By the Way.
Hello. 2 weeks ago, a friend of ours has left Danplan and has made a video about me.
The video was 55 minutes long, and it was a mixture of responding to Steven's initial video and responding to Steven's stream whilst providing receipts throughout. Dan claims that Steven and a person referred to only as his associate stated that if he did not receive 33% of the shares and revenue of the company, then he will leave Danplan.
19. Steven asked if I could get on a call with them to discuss about our VidCon and Disneyland trip. which made sense to me. So I said yes, because I had to buy him his tickets and I needed his passport information anyway. So I got on the call. But that was not what he wanted to talk about. When I got on the call, instead of talking about VidCon or Disneyland, him and another associate of his was on the other line. Steven has said that he heard from Hosta that we were making more money now. So I said yes. But then Steven continued to say with his associate that if he doesn't get 33% of the company and the revenue, that he is going to leave the channel. And that there is no other reason for him to stay.
Daniel said that Steven valued his 30 to 40 minutes of recording time the same as himself and Hosta's contribution, and that that made him angry.
Threatening me with it, the fact that he valued his 30 to 40 minutes of recording the same with the amount of sacrifice and effort that Hosta and I put onto the channel was insulting, and it made me angry. At the time, I felt betrayed that he held no remorse of leaving, that he had no sympathy for our hard work, and that he suddenly changed his mind about everything that he used to say about YouTube now that we're making more money. Obviously, I was happy to give him more money. We were making more money, so to pay him for his talents is fine. But I was angry at his approach. So we fought.
People liken this series of videos to a messy divorce, and in some ways it was, as almost all parties involved seem to have really cynical views on one another. Steven claimed that Dan is obsessed with money and didn't feel like he was part of the Danplan family, while Dan states that if he didn't view him as a friend, he wouldn't have taken him to VidCon, Disneyland, or any of the other things that he did. Ultimately, this comes down to how both individuals viewed shares. Steven viewed it as greater trust and worth, and Daniel viewed it as something only originals could get. Even though Steven himself could have been classified as an original, Dan didn't exactly think that he was. Both Steven and Daniel, in Steven's stream and Daniel's response video, both apologized to the animators publicly. Remember the whole full-time work conversation? Well, Daniel completely destroys that by saying that they are not full-time employees, they are subcontractors. The animators do a contracted job, they do their own work as their own entity, and they agree on a price.
And definitely not the least topic on the animators. First and foremost, I've already apologized to them privately, but I want to apologize again. I am sorry that all of you are caught up in this. It's not your problem that Steven and I had a spat, and it's not your problem that we are taking this out in publicly. You should not be involved in this. I know it's not just stress for me, but for you all as well. And I am so, so, so sorry that you're involved in this.
And also stated that in the past, if animators did not feel as though they were receiving proper payment for their work, they could talk to him and they could work something out.
Hey, they can talk to me. Because there has been times where, you know, we would discuss, me and an animator, hey, do you think this is good enough? And they tell me, I don't know, do you think it's good enough? And we come to an agreement. And if they aren't happy with it, we can meet somewhere in the middle.
Now, before I go into my opinion and the outro, I want to talk about a YouTuber named Snazzle. And this YouTube channel, in my opinion and from what I have seen, is hypocritical. Now, I know people throw around that statement a lot, but he called out Dan all the time for almost everything during the situation.
How could you mistreat everyone like that? Even if you just look at them as employees, even if they're just employees to you, you haven't even compensated them as an employer. You're not even treating them like an employer should. I hate Dan. Dan, I hate that you have turned the word employee into a bad thing. That word for me is ruined. Because an employee, even if you are an employee, You can still be looked up to by the employer. Employee does not mean you should be mistreated. You're doing a service for someone. How have you taken that and made it such a morbid idea? How have you ruined that word for people? What are you doing, Dan? What are you doing, man? This is disgusting. Please, please come out and say something. Please apologize. Please let people know you can change at least a little, please. There has to be some humanity in you. This can't happen. You have to see now that this is wrong. There has to be some fundamental click going on in your mind that says, hey, this is wrong. I'm doing something wrong. Everyone's telling me I'm doing something wrong, but I'm not seeing it. Why am I not seeing it? Why can't I not see it? Where is that at, Dan? Where's the click? I don't get it from you. None of this makes any sense. How could you be at this right now? How could this level of incompetency happen? How could you be so impudent as to not pay for your staff to get what they need?
So, Snazzle, you call Dan incompetent, then do a live stream to raise money for animators who weren't even being that underpaid in the first place. Do you have any proof of them being underpaid? If they are subcontractors and they agree to this amount on principle, and then you make a 20-minute long video saying, hey, I could absolutely ruin Danplan, but I'm not going to, is the height, the very height of incompetence and stupidity, Snazzle. I don't blame you for not wanting to release private conversations, but by you raising $4,000 for these animators or over the charity stream, but not even justifying your narrative and just ending it in a bullcrap cop-out way and leaving it as this, is going to lose you a lot of respect in the community. Many people have compared this response to Jeffree Star's response, and it's a fair comparison to make, all things considered. By ending the drama when a viewpoint came out that was different and framing that as the right thing to do. But where was the right thing to do when you're preaching at Daniel for incompetence and encouraging staff members who are vital to his channel to leave? You can hate me for this, but I will be siding with Daniel. He might have done some shitty things as a boss, but we've got a reverse tardy James Charles on our hands here. What do I mean by that? Well, people took Stephen J. and Snazzle's narratives without evidence and presented them as the truth, and even when Dan came out with receipts to disprove some of their narratives, people still absolutely shunned him. And that is stupid in my opinion, because you've got a lot of testimonies but no evidence, and when evidence does actually come out, you continue to ignore it. In Steven's video, he gave a testimony that sounded like a frustrated employee who quit. In Jay's video, he's perceived as an outsider looking into the situation from neutrality. Snazzle is presented as a harsher critiquer of Dan. Dan made his video disproving some of the evidence from Steven's videos. And with Snazzle's final video, although I don't like him telling us, hey, let's just end the drama, people, he is right about Danplan making people happy and they need to put this behind them. Danplan made loads of people happy, but that was ultimately undone due to Steven's departure. With that said, most people have moved on and the channel has been declared dead by several people. So Danplan, actually Steven, Odd J Alter and Snazzle, welcome to the YouTube graveyard. By the way, boys, I just have one simple thing to ask of all of you. If you could please subscribe to the channel, that would help me out a lot, because only about 17% of people who are watching my videos, and I think it might even be a little bit lower, are subscribed to my channel. So if you could subscribe, it would help me immensely. People liken this series of videos to a messy divorce, and in some ways it was, as almost all parties involved seem to have cynical views on one another. Steven claimed that Dan is obsessed with money and didn't feel like he was playing a part of me.